Hi, I'm here with Travis Moore, who is the director of TechCongress. So tell us what TechCongress is.
Yeah, thanks, Bruce. So TechCongress, we place computer scientists, engineers, and other technologists to work in Congress through a one-year fellowship. They serve as tech policy advisors to some of the leading members of Congress, people like Mark Warner, like Ron Wyden, like Amy Klobuchar, and they improve the technical capacity of Congress.
How long have you been doing this?
So we're in our fourth year, we're in our fourth class of fellows, and we're slowly growing.
So this is an improved Congress we have you're saying.
It is. You probably saw the Zuckerberg hearings. Those really put on display what I experienced for 6 years working in Congress, which is that the Congress has a lot of technology capacity problems and could use some help.
So how many fellows are there in any year, in this year?
Yeah, so right now we have 9 fellows on the Hill, which may sound like not a lot.
It sounds like none, actually.
it is a low number, but the beauty of Congress is there are 3,500 legislative staff working in the entirety of Capitol Hill. And on any given issue, there's really only one staffer that matters. So if you care about HIV/AIDS policy, you call Barbara Lee's office. If you care about surveillance policy, you might call Ron Wyden's office. And so the theory of change is very much that if we can swap out the seats of lawyers and economists for technologists, we can really make a big difference with a handful of people.
So you're looking for more than 9.
What? Yes.
At this point, why is it only 9? What's limiting it? Is it supply? Is it demand? Is it funding?
Yeah, it's not supply at all. I should say we had over 400 applicants for our last application.
So you
cycle.
Could, in theory, put someone in every single
sure.
congressional staff if you had...
If we had money.
Okay, so funding.
If we had money and if we had, to be frank, our process, the fellows get to choose where they go, which is fantastic. You go into TechCongress, you're a fellow, you get to work for your political hero on the issues you care about. But the fellows need to go to the evangelizers. They need to go to the members of Congress that are already bought in on the belief that technology is reshaping society and we need expertise to understand how that's happening. So there are a limited number of kind of receptors. There's certainly more than 9 great offices to be in, but I do think that we probably top out at 20-25, just because we do want to focus on the members that are really the leaders on tech issues.
What about the staff for committees, right? Mm-hmm. Not associated with a particular legislator,
yeah.
but with a committee.
Yeah.
Is there
yeah.
room for them there too?
Yes, absolutely. So right now we have fellows with the Energy and Commerce Committee, which has a plurality, if not a majority, of the tech jurisdiction in the House. Homeland Security Committee. We've had fellows with the House Oversight Committee, with the Senate Homeland Security and Governmental Affairs Committee. So they work for both members of Congress in their personal offices and on the committee staff.
So tell me where they come from. Are these people who are newly computer scientists, newly technologists? Are they later in their career?
Yeah, they're mostly mid-career. So the average fellow has anywhere between 8 and probably 14 years experience. And they really come from a variety of backgrounds. We've had people that have come out of big tech companies that you know well. We have a lot of fellows that come actually out of military service because folks that have been deployed and are working on tactical communications or on surveillance, they have an understanding of the tech because they've been deploying it on the ground.
So it's your fourth year, 3
yep.
years of alums.
Yep.
What are the alums doing? Where do they take this knowledge?
Yeah.
Where do they go with it?
Yeah, so we're really proud. Most of them are becoming leaders in the public interest tech sector broadly. So we've got a handful that are still in Congress, and that's a huge win for us. Out of 3,500 legislative staff, there are only 9 staffers that have any formal technical training. It's a low
that
number.
Doesn't bode well.
but 4 of those are our alumni. And so, for example, we have a fellow who's converted and is now a senior staffer for Senator Wyden. He helped break a story that the Russians were targeting members of Congress on their Gmails ahead of the midterms. We have a fellow that's leading the Cambridge Analytica investigation and has stayed on with Senator Blumenthal. We have others. We have a fellow that went to the Center for Democracy Technology, and he's leading their election security work, so helping state and local election offices shore up their voting machine processes. So really broadly, we also had a fellow that went to Microsoft, but she's in a role that's very much looking at ethics and diversity and inclusion at Microsoft. So a much kind of broader, more holistic, kind of purpose-driven role.
So, and you're focused on U.S. Congress.
Correct.
What What role is there for technologists at the state level, at local government?
Yeah, huge, huge. I mean, we need to scale this. This is a Congress. Obviously, we saw the Zuckerberg hearings. Congress has some technical problems, but this is a problem that every level of government has. Here, right here in San Francisco, the Board of Supervisors is debating a bill to ban facial recognition. At the state level, you've got California implementing its privacy law.
And also IoT security law.
Exactly, exactly. So this is a problem that every level of government has. And the truth is the government knows that it has this problem. What we're doing is priming the pump for demand. Because government knows it has a problem, it knows it needs people that understand technology, cybersecurity. It doesn't know how to source them. It doesn't know what attributes it needs. So we sit at this intermediary level. But we have to scale this because decent, functional, independent government requires technical expertise in house.
So scaling right now for you is not a matter of supply. You've got more than you need.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's sort of a matter of demand, but mainly a matter of funding.
Mainly a matter of funding. Yeah. So we're all funded by public interest foundations. That's important because the fellows need to be free to work on whatever they want to work on without conflict of interest. But relying on grant dollars is, it takes a lot to convert a foundation to raise money. So
what do you know about what's happening in other countries? Are we the only country that has a program like this?
We are.
The EU does not.
Interestingly enough, we're having a convening with the EU in 6 weeks because the EU delegation is sponsoring, where we're going to have our fellows to share with the 27 EU member states our model. We're the only program in the world that I'm aware of that's bringing technical expertise into the policymaking process at the highest levels. And so, we have this problem at state, local, federal in the United States, but everybody else has this challenge as well.
And also international organizations. I can imagine you can place people at the OECD, at the UN, at all these organizations that need tech.
Yeah.
So how do we scale this?
So I think universities are part of the answer. If you go to law school, if you go to Stanford or you go to Berkeley or you go to Harvard or you go to any of the top law schools, you can go and spend 2 or 3 years after graduating doing public service, doing legal aid, being a public defender. And that's because there are scholarship for service programs or tuition reimbursement programs. We really need to replicate that model in computer science and engineering and informatics and other programs across the country. I think universities really have the answer. If you're a political science student, you can go get an intern. Every university has a program to place them as interns in Congress. We need to be building out pathways for our computer scientists and engineers to do the same.
I think this is important, right? All the major policy issues of our century are going to involve technology.
Absolutely, absolutely. We like to say tech isn't a slice of the policymaking pie. It's not health or education or transportation or finance. It's the crust of all of those issues. It's baked into every piece.
That's right. Yeah. And it's whether it's finance and Bitcoin or health and computerized medical devices.
Exactly.
Or now we're talking about AI and decision making.
Yeah.
I think it's fantastic what you do, and I hope there's a lot more of us.
Yeah. Well, thanks for having me. And if you know any good candidates, people can always nominate at techcongress.io/nominate. We're always recruiting. So we're always looking for great new folks.
Cool.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bruce.